Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Early Early Show Live. Here's your host, Robbie Rooster.
Welcome to the Early Early Show, everyone. I'm your host, Robbie Rooster. We have a very special show for you this morning, A Stranger in the Manger. With us are four guests ready to give their account of the events of the first Christmas. Please welcome Doug Donkey, Chloe Cow, Sam Sheep, and Katie Camel. Let's start with you, Doug. Welcome.
Thanks for having me, Ronnie.
It's Robbie.
Oh, it is?
Doug, do you remember meeting the baby Jesus?
Oh, he was a cutie. Just a little cutie. He had the cutest little dimple.
You saw the baby Jesus?
Saw him. I carried him all the way to Bethlehem.
I thought he was born in Bethlehem.
He was, but who do you think carried his mama all across the desert?
Was it you?
Well, it wasn't a jackrabbit.
I never thought it was. When did you know that this baby Jesus was going to be special?
I knew Jesus was special before he was even born.
How?
Because of his mother and father. They kept talking about him on the way to Bethlehem. Couldn't stop talking about him. Now, mind you, most parents are like that, even if their kid is a goober.
Tell me about it.
But not all parents find out about their baby from an angel. An angel went to Mary and said, "You're gonna have a baby." Then he went to Joseph and said, "All that stuff Mary told you about the baby is true." Next thing you know, I'm saddled up with Mary and the baby trotting along to Bethlehem.
That's quite a story.
You ain't kidding. I was stopping for a drink of water when I first heard it. I was so stunned that I did a spit take.
Really?
Water shot out my nostrils. It was kind of embarrassing.
But did you really believe he was a gift from God when you heard about the angels?
Well, I was a little skeptical at first. Most times when you hear about guys talking about seeing angels, they turn out to be a little nuts. But then the baby is born, and these shepherds come and some wise guys.
I'm sure you meant wise men.
I don't know how wise they were. They brought gold and spices to a newborn baby. You know what a baby needs? Diapers.
But you saw all these things.
Yes, and when I saw them, I believed. This was no regular baby. This was a special baby, and he did have a cute dimple.
Well, thanks for sharing your story, Doug. We'll be right back after this break with another animal and a story about the baby Jesus. So give it up for our house band. Sing along if you know the song.
Lord, the newborn king, Lord.
Welcome back. Now for our next guest, please welcome Chloe. Welcome, Chloe.
Thanks for having me, Bobby.
It's Robbie.
It is?
Chloe, I understand you live in the stable where the baby Jesus was born.
What a sweet little angel face. He was so cute. He had the sweetest giggle. And that dimple. Oh, that dimple was adorable.
You remember the baby Jesus being born?
I'll never forget it.
You must have been thrilled to see him.
Absolutely not.
What?
I was not thrilled with having a bunch of people in my house that night.
But it was...
All day long, Greg the goat kept saying, the inn is filling up, they're filling out the rooms. And no way they're sending people out here. Stables are for animals, not people. Well, what do you think happens about in bedtime?
People in the stable?
A man, a donkey, and a pregnant woman who immediately went into labor.
She went into labor right away.
As ready as she was, I'm surprised she made it to Bethlehem.
But she had the baby in the stable.
Oh, yes, and it was very difficult to sleep when somebody's giving birth.
I guess so.
Cow has to have a sleep, Bobby.
It's Robbie.
And you can't sleep when somebody's trying to birth a baby.
I see your point.
Oh, but the little baby was born, you knew it was special.
You knew right away?
Well, the star and the shepherds kind of clued me in. But yes, the baby changed everything. The whole stable just felt different because of his presence.
I guess that made everything okay, huh?
Well, almost. I was still mad at the innkeeper.
What for?
Because you don't put a baby into a stable, especially if the baby is the son of God.
That's a good point.
So, the innkeeper didn't have any milk for a few days.
Uh-oh.
Yes, and boy were his customers mad when he didn't have milk for their frosted flakes.
Frosted flakes? Who ever heard of frosted flakes in ancient Bethlehem?
Well, who ever heard of a talking cow?
That's a good point. We've been talking to Chloe the cow, resident of Bethlehem, about her memories of the baby Jesus.
Oh, that dimple.
Well, we'll see you right after this in another amazing Animal Christmas story. Please enjoy this week's edition of Carpool Karaoke. manger. My next guest today was not in the stable when Jesus was born, but she was there when God sent a special invitation to visit the newborn king. Please say hello to Sam the sheep. Thanks for joining us, Sam. You know, I haven't seen you since Santa Claus came to town.
Wee dogs, thank you for having me, Jerry.
It's Robbie. Okay, Robbie the rooster. Haven't you seen me on TV before?
Shucks, no, Jerry. I'm a sheep. We don't get no TV out there in the green pastures. You know, the one beside the still waters.
Is that near the shadow of the Valley of Death?
No, it's near Bethlehem.
That's right. You were in the field when the angels came to share the good news of Jesus with the shepherds.
Sure was.
So what was it like seeing those angels appear in the sky?
Oh, Jerry, it was so pretty, so pretty. Them angels came out of nowhere, and their halos and their wings and them instruments, what do you call them things?
Harps?
That's the deal. Anyways, they commenced in singing glory to the God in the highest and peace on earth. It was the most glorious singing I've ever heard.
And what did the shepherds do?
Oh, golly, Robbie. They were so scared, they were just sore afraid.
Sore afraid?
That's right, sore afraid. One of them quaking in his boots, another hiding in his eyes. One of them thought the angels had come to take him to glory. He grabbed on himself, Stella!
Yeah. Poor fellow.
Nah, but they were real happy. When they calmed down and heard what yon angels had to say, they were all like, y'all, we should go see this thing that happened in Bethlehem. And then they were like, yeah, we should go see the thing that the angels learned about.
Did you get to go with them?
Of course I did. I had to sing this thing for myself, Jerry.
What do you remember?
Well, he was tiny, and he was sleeping inside a manger, and he had the cutest little dimple. Afterwards, the shepherd headed back to the fields, praising God and telling all of us about the baby.
Amazing.
You know, Jerry, it always seemed kind of odd to me why the good Lord would invite a bunch of smelly shepherds to his newborn son. But I think God was just being neighborly. He sent Jesus for everyone. So he wanted to make sure everyone knew they were welcome, even smelly shepherds.
A beautiful message to end this interview.
And the smelly one. I mean it, Jerry. They do not bathe at all.
Thanks for joining us, Sam. We'll see you right after our house band gives us a little tune on the early, early show live. Sing along if you know this one as well.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies, with angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the in time, behold him come, offspring of the Virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity. Pleased as man with man to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel.
Good morning and welcome back. I'm Robbie Rooster. My final guest today traveled a very long way to see baby Jesus, but I think we can all agree that it was a wise decision. And please welcome Katie the Camel. Hey, Katie, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Robbie. It's a pleasure, dear boy.
You You know my name.
Of course I do. Robbie Rooster. You're a fine talk show host, and I love your work.
Well, I'll be darned. Do you know that you're the only person today who got my name right?
Well, you pick up a few things hanging out with the wise men.
I guess so.
That's how I came to meet the baby Jesus, you know. My master and a few colleagues spotted his star in the sky, and we all set off on a long journey.
Did you know that you were going to go see someone special?
We most certainly did. They don't call them wise men just for being good Monopoly players, you know.
I guess not.
My master and his fellows had read the prophecies of the ancient Israelites, telling the time and the way in which the new king would be born. As soon as they saw the star, they knew that they had to look for themselves.
And the star led you to Bethlehem?
No, no, dear boy. It led us to Jerusalem. That's where the king is, you know, and he was quite puzzled when we asked about the newborn king. Thankfully, the king had some fairly wise fellows of his own, and they opened the book of Micah to say, "You will find him in Bethlehem."
How wise of you to ask for directions.
Well, being wise doesn't mean you have to have all the answers, but it means being smart enough to ask for help when you need it.
So you go to Bethlehem and you see the baby Jesus.
Oh, what a little pumpkinhead. He was so cute.
That's what I hear.
He had the cutest dimple.
I heard that one too.
My master and his associates brought gifts for him. They brought gold, a spice called frankincense, and an oil called myrrh. These were gifts fit for a king, so it was rather strange seeing them in the hands of such poor parents. I could tell they had never seen such things in all their lives.
They must have been really overwhelmed.
They were, but not nearly as much as my master, you see. The gifts we brought were nothing compared to the boy. He was the Son of God. He was the Redeemer of the world. He would bring something far more valuable than gold or frankincense or myrrh. He would bring eternal life.
How true.
I still get people today asking me about our journey. What did the star look like? How much gold did he bring? How long did it take to get there? I tell them none of that really matters. We are not the story. The gift and the manger is the real story of Christmas.
Wise words from a very wise camel.
My pleasure, Robbie.
This has been the Early Early Show Live. I'm Robbie Rooster, and now you know the story of the animals in the Nativity. Let's give it up one more time for our house band. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Noel, 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 Noel. Oh.
coming, everyone. There are drinks, food, and refreshments in the fellowship hall. Thank you.